On March 26th, Nintendo dropped a surprise, a mini direct presentation revealing new information about many upcoming Nintendo titles. A direct of any kind is always a thrilling event for Nintendo fans, especially for Smash fans, as this is where we'll get news of DLC fighters inbound. In the Byleth presentation back in January, Sakurai revealed that there would be a whole new Fighters Pass, featuring not 5, but 6 more DLC characters coming to Smash Ultimate. As the Smash logo appeared on the screen during the mini direct, we all held onto our seats with excitement and a little bit of anxiety for the reveal of a new fighter. Would the announcement bring a wild third-party collaboration like Joker and Cloud did, or would we just get another polarizing first-party character like Byleth? Well, everyone has their own impressions, but objectively, many of us were a little bit disappointed and even shocked when the theme song of ARMS played, signaling the news that the next fighter would be a character from a bizarre third-person fighting game. The identity of the character was unrevealed, but more info is to be announced sometime this month alongside with the character's release. ARMS released for the Switch on June 16, 2017. The game plays from a third-party perspective and 3D environments, with the original characters using extendable arms to fight from long distances. ARMS makes use of the motion features on the Switch's Joy-Cons to allow players to throw and curve their punches, although button control options are also available. 15 characters were playable at launch, with 5 more added as DLC. Each character has a set of unique arm option, which offers a different ability such as elemental attacks like freezing opponents with ice. Competitively, many fans of Nintendo's tournament games like Smash and Splatoon were initially attracted, but only a few have stayed with the game, nurturing its small competitive scene over time. News of an ARMS character in Smash comes as a surprise, as the game was released over 2 years ago and struggles to even remain relevant. After the announcement of Smash, a trial was revealed alongside subscribers of Nintendo Switch Online to play the entire ARMS games for free for a period of time. This would further imply that the ARMS character in Smash is purely a promotional decision, but there are a few more possibilities which we will mention in this video. Before that though, our question of the day is, who would you like to see as the next DLC character in Smash? Let us know in the comments down below and stay tuned for more insight on the ARMS character. To learn how to play the new character upon release and for all your competitive Smash resources, you can check out ProGuides.com. We've got character guides and aggregated tier lists, as well as pro courses taught by top players like MKLeo and ESAM. For an even more personalized approach, get yourself a personal coach via our Play With Pros platform today. We've also recently assembled a team of streamers to keep you guys entertained and educated at all time. You can catch our free YouTube streams weekdays at 12 p.m. PST right here, so make sure you subscribe and click that bell so you always get notified when we're live. Now before we even discuss how the ARMS character might play in Smash, we need to throw out some ideas as to which character will be chosen from the ARMS roster, if they're even from the ARMS roster. Springman is the most obvious pick as the mascot of the ARMS franchise. He's basically the Mario of that game, with a basic balanced moveset that represents the game in its purest form. Springman is... Okay, I hear you. We all know that Springman is an assist trophy in Smash, but guess what? That means nothing. This might be the dream for the Waluigi characters, all I'm saying. Assist trophies, spirits, Mii costumes, none of these really determine whether a character can make it into Smash. As has been confirmed on multiple occasions, Nintendo chooses the DLC picks, and if they want the character to be in the game so badly enough, little issues like this won't stop them at all. In fact, we've already seen it happen. Little Mac was an assist trophy in Brawl before even being introduced as a fighter in Smash 4. Every playable character in Ultimate has their own spirit already, and King K. Rool was Mii costume before he was even a playable character. So, Springman is still on the table, guys. He's not the only option though. Ribbon Girl is another iconic character from ARMS who features multiple jumps and an air dash mechanic that might be neat in Smash. Twintel was one of the most talked about ARMS character when she was released, and because of this, it would probably mean that it would please fans with her inclusion. The one thing that makes Twintel a little bit less likely, however, is that she doesn't actually have extendable arms like the other ARMS fighters. Instead, she's just using her hair to throw punches. This might not matter at all, but the mini direct does specifically state that the fighter's arms can extend, which, taken literally, Twintel's cannot. It's also possible that the ARMS character will be the one that is currently not even released in ARMS. It's a bit curious that they revealed the game the character is coming from, but without even revealing who the character is. And why would they do this? It's possible that they just wanted to reveal the character along with the polished gameplay footage in Smash. But it could also mean the fighter is an upcoming DLC in addition to both Smash and ARMS. This would be a great way for Nintendo to even promote ARMS, Smash, and maybe even a third game. Heroes out here. In one of Nintendo's biggest recent announcements, the new Paper Mario title, The Origami King, was revealed. In it, Mario is shown with the ability that allows him to extend his arms. What if the new character in Smash is also a new character in ARMS, and that character is Paper Mario? Or it could just be Springman, but we'll find out soon. All right, now let's go over some potential for the character's moveset. No matter what character it is, even Paper Mario, every ARMS character fights more or less the same, using slow attacks that can reach very far and can be angled. We've seen a few characters before who have just been described as distance demons, such as the Byleth and the Belmonts, but none have as quite much melee range as an ARMS character should. Looking at the Spring Man assist trophy, we could see that his max range seems to extend a little bit further than a Belmont's forward smash, and remaining accurate to ARMS, the character would have this range on their entire moveset. Interestingly, Spring Man's ARMS will return to him after connecting a punch. This is relevant as an ARMS character takes quite a long time for their punch to travel to max distance, but come out pretty quickly in close ranges. If this concept is maintained in the Smash Fighter, we could see a character with a range who doesn't really suffer from slow frame data up close unless they whiff. Whiffing at an attack range this close would force the character to go through the full range punch animation, leaving them wide open. It's also possible that the distance of the punches will be reworked so that it'll just be controlled by the duration of the button press, for example. A very important factor would also be whether or not the character's extended arms and fists will be disjointed. A disjointed hitbox is a hitbox that doesn't have a hurtbox. For example, you can hit Mario's arm during his forward air because it's part of his body and has a hurtbox. But Mark's forward air uses a sword with a disjointed hitbox, so attacking his sword won't really hurt him. If the arms character doesn't have a disjointed punch, then this will make him vulnerable from even further away. Sort of like Piranha Plant at the end of its down B. Because of this, the arms will most likely be disjointed, but it's possible that they'll be still interrupted by the opponent's attacks. In the arms game, there's a weight-based priority that allows heavier arms to punch through lighter arms, and we could definitely see something like this occur in Smash as well. Every character in ARMS has a massive range on everything that they do, and this includes grabs. The ARMS fighter in Smash will most definitely have a tether grab, and it just might be the longest range tether grab in the game. The viability of this really depends on the frame data. If the grab follows the trend mentioned earlier of starting quickly but taking time to travel to max distance, it could function as a useful grab in close quarters and act as a shield callout at longer range. Most tether grabs in Smash suffer from slow startup and long cooldown, making them risky despite their range, so we'll have to wait and see if this grab falls into the same category. There's a good chance that the ARMS fighter will also use a tether recovery. They seem to like giving tether up Bs to DLC fighters, but either way, this makes the most sense for a character that can really only punch and jump in their source game. That's actually one of the main issues with designing a moveset of an ARMS character, because they really only have one attack. Although the devs will likely craft a few original animations to diversify the punches, we think that the fighters will also be able to make use of multiple arm options as well. This could be implemented in a few different ways. First, the fighter could use a more basic default arm set for the normal attacks and aerials, with different tilts and aerial directions simply changing the angles of the punches. If this is the case, the neutral side and down specials could be attacks with other arms that have special abilities. Another possibility is that the character will be going through a cycle of different arms with their entire moveset using something like a down special. This would offer a lot of creativity and diversity as the different arms would likely have completely different attributes and even different frame data. In order to access the special ability of arms in, well, arms, the player must also charge the arms by dashing, jumping, or blocking. This could be easily carried over to Smash, or an independent option like a neutral special could be used to charge punches. Dashing could be represented with rolls or as a unique movement option, potentially with their side special. Many ARMS characters also have the special abilities that involve their charging. Spring Man can release his charge to deflect attacks, and Twintail can slow down enemy ARM attacks while charging. Either of these could be implemented in Smash as a counter-style move, with Twintail working similar to Witch Time. Oh, no. Lastly, ARMS features a rush mechanic that activates when a rush meter is filled up. A rush allows the fighter to rapidly throw out multiple punches and deflect weaker attacks. We can see the Spring Man assist trophy perform a rush at the end of his active time. At first glance, this seems like the perfect choice for the ARMS character's final smash, but this is a DLC character, and it involves a meter. So, this very well could somehow find itself making an appearance as one of Smash's infamous comeback abilities. If so, it would be very similar to KO Punch or Limit, wherein the character loses the ability after using it. At this point, we'll just have to wait and see. It won't be long before the ARMS character drops, so let us know what you're expecting in the comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe to ProGuides and turn on notifications to keep up with the future uploads. Stay safe, stay healthy, and have a wonderful day. Peace.